Hello everyone, welcome back to Pavlov VR, the series where we evaluate every gun in Pavlov to determine which one is the best in its own category, and maybe even eventually find the best one altogether. I believe it was 2 days ago, I did the pistols and shotguns, and what we learned out was that the pump is the best one of the shotguns, and the best pistol is the Deagle. Which, to be honest, I was expecting, because I think the Deagle is the best pistol. But, you know what? If you like any of these other pistols or any of the other shotguns, go for it. I have not tested them in actual combat yet, and I will do that probably in a future series where it'll be actual hand-to-hand combat with these weapons. But for right now, it's just to try it out, check the recoil, check the accuracy, the bullet explosions. As when I say explosion, I'm just talking about like how much of a radius, diameter of the bullet holes, just to see or get a guesstimation of the damage. So today, to just jump right into it, I will be examining each SMG to determine which one's the best. And let's just get right into it. So starting off with, I absolutely despise this gun. Every time I've used it, I have died. It is so bad, but I will still test it out for you guys. I believe it's the Scorpion. And then this is the, I believe, the Uzi. It's an okay gun. I mean, the only time I really use these guns is during gun game. And I think this one's okay. I think this one's horrible. But just to test it, let's start off with the Uzi. So, sorry, I apologize. Before we get into it, I should say that these are all going to be in brackets. So, like, these are going to be in a bracket together. This and this is going to be in a bracket. The P90 and this is going to be in a bracket. This is going to be in a bracket with this, and yada, yada, yada. You get the gist. So, every two guns are going to be in its own bracket, and then they're all going to fight against each other to figure out which one's the best SMG. Now we can get started. So, from a previous comment on the first video of the series, they told me that 40 meters is about how far you want to fight with a SMG and assault rifle. So I will be using their suggestion today for the training and for the testing purposes. I will be keeping the 0.5 meters to get a general idea of close range, but 40 meters will also be used. So getting started. Okay, that's the entire mag. So from what I can tell, not a lot of bullets. But you can see that it's all over the place. It's just absolutely a mess. The mag is not very huge. The bullet holes are not very big, doing lackluster damage. Yeah, I mean, it's whatever. Scorpion. Okay. Surprisingly, it looks like they're about the same amount of damage. It looks like I just hit that spot twice, but it just has less ammo. So it's just a worse version of the Uzi. So I guess now let's begin with the 40. I think the Uzi won that for the first round. Let's check out the 40 now. Okay, let's see. Okay, this is impossible with this type of gun. So, yeah, I'm not even going to try this. 40, I do not believe, is good enough. I do believe that the commenter is probably right with, like, some of these longer weapons. But for, like, these small ones, yeah, I'm sorry, but they're just not going to do any good damage at that range. I can just already tell. So, even this, I think, is too far, but we'll just do this. Okay, well that was absolutely disgusting. I don't even know if I hit a shot, and then might as well just get this going. Oh, I have no ammo. Okay. Okay, that recoil is crazy. I don't even know if these... Okay, that's just garbage, and that's garbage. Oh! I think I hit more shots with the Scorpion than with the Uzi. I don't know. Like, I think maybe 40 might be too long and 20 might be too long. You might want to shoot these at 10. Okay, well, I'll give each one more try at 10, but 20 and 40 are not happening probably with these weapons. Okay, finger. Oh. Okay. Yeah, this is definitely what you're going to be shooting at these guns with. Still all over the place, but I do like how fast this gun is. I feel like the Scorpion, even though I hate its accuracy and I honestly do not like it, I still think that it has a really fast shooting, but with this lower mag, it's just not very great to me. And from what I can tell, I still think the Uzi wins over it by just a little bit. But I'm pretty sure the Uzi is not going to get much farther. But we have a lot of guns to go, so I'm gonna have to give the Uzi that win. Just this doesn't look very great. I mean, both don't look very great. Really, the only reason the Uzi's winning is because of the mag size. But I mean, yeah. So I guess let's just start off with whatever this weapon is. I think this is an SMG. Sorry if I'm wrong, but I honestly don't know what this is. So we're gonna be using that and whatever this gun is. Made in the USA. Something, something, something. Okay. I guess let's just start off with whatever this is. Ooh, okay. Definitely better than the Uzi so far. Can this go down here? No. Okay. Let's try this thing out. So it's got a scope. I'm moving it to my left eye so that you can see it. But it's got a scope, so it could be a little bit better to shoot with in some cases. Okay. All right. So initial ideas is that this gun is going to be good at longer ranges. But I mean, I think this one has a little bit more bullets in the chamber, or I guess in the magazine. So I think that this gun may have just beat it. But let's see what it is at. See, I feel like it'd be unfair at 20 though. Because this gun might not be good at 20, but this one could be amazing at it, and it's kind of unfair. So let's keep it at 10. Wait, let's see. Okay, we'll do it. We'll do 20 for this round because I think both of them are able to do it. Okay. We'll move you to 20 also. Okay, let's see. Oh, that recoil is bad. That recoil is not very great at that range. Yep. Oh, okay. Yeah, I don't know if I don't know. This one is not very good recoil at that range either. But I mean, that's a lot better. Definitely a lot better. There was only like two shots off. This one is all over the place. Man. Okay, this is where we're going to get into a use case scenario. I think this is a really good long range SMG, but this one could be a lot better close range. So, honestly, I think really. Okay, I'm just going to quickly do 10 to get a general idea, but I think I'm going to have to give it to a long range one because it's better in most use case scenarios, I'm guessing. So, okay, let's see. Okay, that doesn't look horrible. Doesn't look horrible either. Okay. I still hit most of my targets. So, can I get a scope on this? I can. Okay. Let's see. One more, but with an actual scope, because I feel like it's unfair to have one with a scope and not one without. So let's try this now. Okay, that recoil is still horrible. Yeah, I'm gonna give it to this one. I mean, even with the scope, it's still kind of more of a mess. I'd say pick this gun if it's shorter range, but I'm gonna give it to whatever this monstrosity is. Got a lot of guns, so we gotta hurry this up, hurry this up. Okay, this is a no-go, this is a no-go. So we got the Uzi in that. Okay. Get rid of that for right now. So the P90 versus I don't know what this is. Yeah, I have no clue. Okay. So let's start off with the P90. Okay. Looks pretty good. Both look really good. I think the P90 might have more ammo. This one is all over the place, but I really don't want the P90 to win because I do not like the P90, but I think from now on for SMGs we're gonna keep it at 10 because I feel like anything above is just impossible with a bunch of these SMGs. Okay, I had to stop. Yeah, I mean like this gun is so like the recoil's not great at all. It just has too much horizontal recoil. Not looking great for that gun. This one has a lot of recoil also. Yeah, I mean, these are both just SMGs in general are not very great. Problem is that these shots will probably actually hit for more damage, while these ones are lower body shots. And in most games, and I'm assuming this game, anything that's like in the feet area or like lower body is probably not as much damage as anything up here by the shoulders. This one, at least there is vertical recoil, so it might kick back up to the head, so you might get a lucky shot, but this one just does not seem like that. It just seems like it's all over the place. So I'm gonna give it to this one. Then the P90. I think maybe the P90 would be really good close range, but this is better for medium short range, I say, but the P90 I would say is only good for short range. Okay, going at a pretty good pace, going at a pretty good pace. So then we got I think this is the PP Bison and the Vector. So let's try both these guns. PP Bison. Ooh, really nice ammo count. And look at those bullets. That is so much better than anything over here. Like, all of this is a complete shot in the dark compared to these bullets. Really liking this gun. Okay, the Vector. Okay. Immediately, first off, this has more firepower. This one is, I think, possibly faster. But the only reason why it's really faster is, and it feels faster, is because the magazine is a lot smaller. The fact that it has a smaller magazine and the firepower is a lot less. I think the PP Bison won this round. However, that was close range, so let's try 10 meters. Still might edge it out. Oop. I don't know, that looks pretty good. I don't know if it's going to beat the PP Bison. I might have already reloaded that. Yes, I did. Why did I do that? Okay. All right. Initial thoughts. The firepower is still really good for the PP Bison. I mean, like, even at that range, it just looks stronger than the Vector. I mean, I think the Vector might have a teeny bit more less recoil, but yeah, I'm gonna give it to the PP Bison. Honestly, if you feel like any of these guns are better, please share in the comments and I'll give it maybe a further testing. Like, if you have like a favorite weapon, please tell me and I will do some heavy testing on it just to see if it truly should be your favorite. And who cares if I find out personally if I don't like it? If you like it, then go ahead. Maybe you're just better with that weapon than I am. But I'm gonna give it to the PP Bison. Vector's off the table. Okay, so we got the MP4. I don't know what this. I think it's an MP4. But we got that gun, and then get that out of here for a second. And then I think this is like the ump or something. I don't remember. But let's see. Okay. Good, 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 good. Look at that. All right where I was aiming, too, with just a few outliers. Good so far. Good so far. Okay. Both heavy contenders. Really liking both these weapons. Honestly. Okay. So notice that these bullet holes are a lot more shallow. These ones look a lot more deep and just you can even see through it. Sorry if it's not really seeable through the camera or I guess the TV or whatever you're watching this on. This you can barely see it. You can see maybe a little bit right there. But okay, so this has more firepower. I'm gonna have to give it to this weapon for sure. Let's do some 10 meters. Okay. Did I already reload this? No, I did not. Okay. A little bit of that might have been my fault. I know that I switched positions too with the guns. That was mostly on accident, but it doesn't really matter if I remember which side is which. So this was the MP4. Okay. Or whatever this. Sorry if I'm butchering the name. MP4. Wait, this is not the MP4. Isn't the MP4 like a video player thing? Like MP3? Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Unless it's called the same thing, but I don't think I just yeah, that I might have made a mistake on that name, but again, I'm not good with names. Okay. I don't know. To be honest, I'm liking the look of this one. There's a lot of good hits right in the middle with I think only one, two, three, four, maybe four misses. One, two, three. Well, I think some of them went off the board, but yeah, okay. I'm gonna have to give it to this. I mean, again, if we were talking about firepower, this is a lot better, especially if the accuracy is nearly undecipherable. It's better. So this wins overall with it might be called the MP4 or the M4P or the whatever, blah 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 blah. But that one moves on. Okay. Think we're going at record pace. I think the pistols and shotguns took a lot longer 2 days ago or whatever. Oh wait, that was it. Oh, that's all of them. Okay. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, okay. That did not take as long as I thought. Okay. So, I think anything against. Oh wait, actually, can I take off the scope? Yes, I can. Okay. We'll do that from now on. So sorry about the first contestant, even though I still think this thing would have won. I think this went against the. I think it went against this and lost. So, apologies to this gun, but I mean. I still think this would have won. So, we'll do that one and we're gonna do the Uzi. This is not really a fair fight, but. Okay. Okay. A lot less ammo in this thing. Honestly, nearly identical at close range. I would say that the Uzi wins though, because it's just a lot more bullets too, so looking good so far. I guess we'll go at 10. I don't even think this thing is gonna be good at 10. Oh, we got some headshots. That's not where I was aiming at, though. Ooh, a lot of headshots. Okay. Yeah, the recoil on all these SMGs are kind of bad, besides like a few. But, honestly. Okay. Honestly, very similar. And it actually looks like I nearly missed none of my shots with this gun. So the accuracy is a lot better, but the mag size I think is better on the Uzi. Man, this is a mixed bag, but I mean I guess if you like this gun, I would say that there is a reason and it's for long range, but I think actually the Uzi is going to win this. However, I think it's so close that either could be interchangeable in the final rounds. So, I'm gonna give it to the Uzi for right now, but maybe in the future it will be better than a bunch of these SMGs. I don't know. So, Uzi is moving forward. I think the P90 did not move forward. So we got two contestants over here, and then I think this one. Or no, wait. Yeah, this one won. This one won, edged out the P90, and then the PP Bison beat the Vector. Okay, cool, 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 cool. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Okay. Oop, there's some bullet holes, probably from that Uzi that I just fired everywhere. Okay, fantastic recoil. Practically none. Okay. I mean, this is really good recoil, but the amount of bullets that is in this, like, almost a drum, is kind of insane, to say the least. I mean, look at all that, versus this. And it doesn't even look like it does enough power. So the PP Bison wins that round, but let's pump it up to... I just clicked five buttons. Let's move that to 10. Let's do this one. Okay. Push that closer. Okay. Again, I think the magazine is gonna be the thing that wins. I mean, like, that's insane. Even if you missed, like, five shots, you still would have killed him at that point. Like, I mean, look at all these shots. It's kind of just insane. This is kind of just like, what is this? This is just, like, a potato chip going into him. It's not going to do anything compared to the PP Bison, so PP Bison wins. No doubt in my mind. So let's get that out of here, and let's keep moving on. All right. Okay. So you got the Uzi, that one over here, you got that. You got... okay. So that failed. I think this one. Okay, so what do we have left? We have this, the PP Bison, the... Sorry, I'm having a brain fart. I think it was this. So you had the Uzi, because it beat that, right? And then that one went out, that one went out, because that one went against that, that one went against that, that went against that, that one against that, this one against that, and that one against that. Okay, so at this point, we just have... I think this is called the ump. I'm probably butchering it again. But then we got the Uzi, and then I think there's one more, right? And I just said it. The PP Bison. Okay. All right. Wow, that went a lot quicker than I thought. I think... what would be an even matchup? I think the Uzi is going to be dropped out, but let's start off with the ump. Okay. Oh, crap. I'm going to have to leave that out for right now. Okay, I don't know if I have to really talk about this gun. I mean, this is a lot better. And if it's already doing this at close range, the Uzi loses. I'm not going to do the 10 meters. You can already tell that it's not going to do good at 20 or, like, any more. So I would recommend the ump. So just immediately ended that round. But, I mean, there's no point in testing it for farther ranges. That leaves only the ump and the PP Bison, which, honestly, these are like the two guns that I play with normally, so makes a lot of sense. Might be a little bit of bias, but... Oh, I keep standing on that. All right. Okay. Okay, wow. So this has a lot more ammo. It has just a lot better qualities to it. As you can see, there is some recoil right there that kept, like, swaying to the right. That was kind of annoying, but I mean, so many bullets, it's just really good. The ump is not nearly as good, so I think the PP Bison is going to win that one. Let's move to 10 meters. This is going to be the final round. This is the final matchup. Let's reload the PP Bison. I can't remember if I reloaded that, so let's just do that again. Okay, and PP Bison time. Okay, that looks pretty good. I just reloaded this. I don't know why I'm doing it again. Okay. I mean, some headshots, that's really good, but not where I was aiming. As always, I always try to aim for the body. I'm not aiming for the head because it's just a lot smaller of a target. It's unfair for a bunch of these guns. If you're aiming for the head, you're probably going to be closer range with like a shotgun, or you're going to be maybe using an AK-47, or maybe you're using a deagle. But like for these SMGs, you're going to be going body shots most likely. So as you can see, way more upper recoil on the ump. And the PP Bison, of course, is hitting exactly where I want it. So, of course, you know who the winner is. You could have probably assumed from the beginning, but I'm definitely gonna have to give the win to the PP Bison. It's definitely better than the UMP. I mean, yeah. And as always, at the end, I always say which one is the worst. So I think the worst pistol is this, as I said, I think yesterday, and or not yesterday, 2 days ago, and then. I can't remember which one I said the worst was here. I think it was the automatic because it's just like I don't think it does a lot of damage from what I remember playing with it. And it honestly is a very huge hit or miss. So it's always better to do like one taps. Oh no, sorry. The double barrel's the worst. I completely forgot that it even existed. That's how bad it was. Yeah, that's definitely the worst. And as you can see, the worst, as you may have noticed, are all in these small form factors compared to their bigger cousins. So you've got like this small little pea shooter, and then you've got this small little shotgun compared to the other three. And today, the Scorpion. And guess what their qualities have? They're all small. So, as you may have guessed, all the smaller weapons are literally the worst ones. And I kind of agree with that. The smaller you get, the worst weapon you get. So, yeah. All in all, I believe that is it for this video. I do not believe that there is any more guns. If I made any mistakes, please do say so in the comments. I will either correct myself in the next video, or I will do nothing about it and I'll just comment and be like, "Thanks for noticing. Sorry about that," you know. So, as always, thanks for watching. Now you know the best SMG, and that would be the PP Bison. So, if you're ever on a voyage in Pavlov and you want to know which guns are the best, immediately and just jump straight right into it, it's definitely got to be the Deagle, the PP Bison, and the Pump Shotty. Okay, turns upside down. That's awesome. Don't have to act like a turtle here, but I mean, that was cringe. Okay, good. Goodbye, everybody. Thanks for watching.